Yes, yes, yes. What is good, my people? Welcome back to Computer Music Academy's weekly homework podcast. I am your host, Tosh Irisay. Thank you for watching and thank you for listening. Welcome to week 137. Good Lord. Of the weekly homework assignment slash podcast, shout out to my man, Ray D3000, for that intro. We'll be using that for the rest of September and then moving on to something else. Shout out to everyone who is rocking with us live right now. We got a nice amount of people. Thank y'all for hanging with us today. We got a great show lined up for you. What are we doing? Well, for those outside of the States, I guess we need to explain it a little bit. So there's this thing that we do called Labor Day in the States, and it's actually one of the major holidays. It's one of the major holidays where government offices are closed and blah, blah, blah. It's the second one. It's always in the, I would say, later half of the year. And really, what it's become, well, let's just say this. It was created to honor the working class people of the United States. What it has become is an off day and a great excuse to barbecue and hang with your family and friends. Especially since it's at the end of summer, basically. Summer still goes on for a couple of weeks until September, but this is marked as the end of the summer because people who are, you know, in the case of somebody like Mr. Wallace, who is an administrator at his school, he's going back to school along with a lot of other people. Anybody working temporary jobs for summer, they may be doing something different in the fall. Kids are going back to school and so many other things. So since this is Labor Day that this podcast just happened to fall on, and since this is the end of the summer, the last hurrah, so to speak, we are having an ode to summer. So what we're doing is creating one of two things: organic tracks that are summer themed. You know what I'm saying? Something you can play at a cookout or at the swimming pool, basketball court, whatever. Or for people who are sample based, you have to go grab, you have to use a song that has a summer theme or a title. So something like Summer Madness by Cool It Again, Sun Goddess by Ramsey Lewis, and so on and so forth. So this is going to be a very interesting episode. So much that we actually have 13 submissions tonight. I am so excited to get to it. But first, let's get with the people over here and see what's going on, man. We got a lot of people checking in right now. The numbers have been increasing every single week. And I thank all of you who rock with us live. And I thank all of you who watch the playback on now. Let me go here real quick. We do this live every Monday night at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time right here on Facebook.com/Computer Music Academy. And we put the high quality official podcast on youtube.com/Computer Music Academy as well as computermusicacademy.com the next day. So you can always check us out, and we have 137 episodes at this point. You have plenty of music to listen to. So with that said, let's get over here and see who's up in here, man. Dixie Freely, Davenport, DJ D-Man, Mr. Wallace, Mike Notes, what up, Miles? Basic Productions, RTO, what up, Ray Jean? What up, Gemini? What up, Agent Smith? My wife, Samaya's in here. Your Fabian Roland, welcome. Miss Pam, Miss Tiffany, Tucson, Miss Lena, checking in so far. Make sure you get your likes in if you have not already, and I would definitely shout you out before the end of the night. No one you know just checked in. Who else? There's a lot of people in here in the chat. What up, Tucson? I don't know if I shouted you out. Jamari Mack is in here. What up, dude? Ron B, my man, Demi Glass is up in here. Man, we got a full house. Full house. I'm loving what's going on right now. I think I got everybody accounted for, so for the moment. So thank y'all for hanging with us. Jelani Canifer, thank you for hanging out. Thank you. That's a new name right there. Thank you for coming through. QB, Quentin Barrett, hanging with us tonight, my dude. All right, let's get on. So, Basement Chemistry, shout out to him. I just saw him pop up. So, we have been having our best year this year. And I think that's very easy to say. A lot of people will agree when I say that. So, with that being said, especially now with the implementation of the live show, we're getting more people to join. We're getting people that we actually respect, know, and love their work to join. And that's where our first submission comes in from a gentleman originally from Philly, now over in VA, if I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong. Pardon me if I am. DMV, let's just say that. But he is one of our good friends. He's been hanging with us for the last several months, and he is nasty on the beats. So shout out to my dude. Welcome him to CMA and the WHA. My man Mental, the God. Yes, sir. Mental the God making his CMA and Weekly Homework podcast debut. A little backstory, I guess. Well, I guess to say a little behind the scenes. This dude actually joined and had his submission ready for last week when we did the Blaxploitation. For some reason, did not turn it in. And it actually turned out very dope. But he didn't play around this week. He got in here. So shout out to my man for that. That was dope. He actually said it's a mixture of samples from Summer Breeze, Summer in the City, and Ella Fitzgerald's Summertime. Very dope. And this is what I like about Mental. Dude is, no one just said, he's grimy. I love Mental's beats. Nice and grimy, like just straight up boom bap. 90s, old school, you know what I'm saying? Lo-fi to a certain extent, but that's what I really, really love about his production. He's very dope. He uses the Machine MK2, so he's another one of us. And dude gets it in. He does. He does a nice amount of live streams. He actually did a Gadget over at Digital Hustle Films. He did a dollar bin, what was it, about 2 months ago? Very, very dope. My man is handling his business, and now he's a part of the team. So shout out to my man Mental for coming through and participating this week. Thank you for that, my man. Good Lord. Who did I just see pop in? Oh, Howard Knox. Shout out to you, sir. Thank you for coming through. That's another one of people I really, 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 we really respect. That dude's beats are nasty. All right, let's keep it going. We're going to head over and holler at the dude who has been coming along. He has been progressing every single week, every single submission. Give it up for my man, Okay Joey. Man, this guy right here. Okay, Joey, continuing the progression, getting better and better every week. I'm loving this dude's work. Not only is his beats coming along and improving, he's picking better sounds. He's experimenting a little more and doing a lot more stuff within his beat. And if you go back to the, you know, the first few joints that he was sending in, it is definitely a difference, and I love that progression. I love his evolution. So shout out to you for that, my man. What's so funny is I was reading his submission. He said, "For me, this is more than a farewell song. To tell you the truth, I hate summer." And he was just talking about the stuff that he used actually came from Golden Hip Hop. Okay, I guess it's a sample pack by Hello Samples. Shout out to Hello Samples, man. If anybody from Hello Samples is watching, get at me. We need to do some business, for real. I would love to do some reviews and some promotion, for real. They are doing their business. Also used some Ill Mind Blap Kit chops and vocals from Father Dub. Dope, very dope. I love what he did with this track. Somebody brought it up in the chat. Talking about the swing on the drums, very dope. I like the percussion that he used and the claps and snares and everything that he had, the bass line that he had, the horn stabs, everything just seemed to fit. And he had a couple of different change-ups. Now, there's one thing I have to call out. I've noticed in the last few submissions, he's done the same thing where he has, I would say, before it goes into that last third of the song, right before it rides out, he's been doing this thing where he hits a reverse up until it actually takes it to that main part again. It's been a few weeks that he's done that. So now, Joey, you got to switch that up a little bit, man. It's good that you're doing more transitions and stuff like that now, but you definitely want to not use that in every single song because people are going to call that out, get sick of it, not pay attention, that kind of thing. Other than that, man, love the submission. Love your progression. You have been killing it. Thank you for being a part of what we do, my man. You are awesome. Let's give some quick shout-outs, man. some people that I may not have hollered at yet. My man L Tone from the Lyricist, my brother. Me and this dude go back. We have done many a show together. We've rocked on, what, 3 songs together. I produced 1 or 2 of theirs. Crazy. So it's good to have my man hanging out with us tonight. Y-Body is in the chat with us. Jay Mitch is hanging with us. Locturnal is with us. Who else we got, man? Who have I not shouted out yet? I shout out all the ladies. Okay, that's all I can see for now. Cool. Welcome. Thank you all for watching. Very, very dope. Let's keep it moving to a gentleman I have been on him. What up the way who just stepped in the chat? To a gentleman that I have been on his head. I have been like, dude, what the hell are you going to do? When are you going to get it in the podcast? And he finally did a couple of weeks back, took a week off. Now he's back with us. So with great pleasure, I'm ready to hear this joint. Shout out to my man, DJ D-Man. DJ D-Man, second submission to the Weekly Homework Podcast and chilling in the chat. Woo, that was fire. I thoroughly enjoyed that, my man. Way to flip Summer Madness. And of course, that's been done hundreds of times possibly, but it's always refreshing when somebody can do something different with it and still make it somewhat recognizable. So you know what song it is, you know, the source material, and you can appreciate it. That's what I'm talking about right there. That is nasty, my man. You are on a path, on a tear right now. I love the chops. I love the, which, you know, the parts that you actually used of Summer Madness. That along with the drums, and you had some nice hi-hats and whatnot in there swinging. Everything was really, really, really dope about this. Couple of change-ups, couple of different things going on, you know, switching up throughout the song. That's what I'm talking about, man. And everybody in the chat agrees. This is crazy. This right here, Doug. Yeah, that's straight heat. Straight heat. Man, who we got here? Is that Big Hub? What's going on with you, man? I said shout out to Wayne. Apologies if I haven't given a shout out to my man Widebody. I thought I did, and I may not have. So a major shout out to him right now. And everybody else that's watching, we still got a long way to go. But DJ D-Man, thank you, sir. That was dope. Very dope. All right, we're going to bring it back up to Detroit. Holla at my man who is another dude that's been killing it, thoroughly killing it. My man, no one, you know. Yes, yes. Told y'all, this dude has been on a tear lately, handling his business. No one, you know, representing. Doug, he says, I figured I'd do something a little more upbeat to end the summer. That felt right. And he used Phyllis Hyman some way. And there were several people in the chat. Some awesome, yo, we need to go skating. I agree. I agree. That is definitely a skating joint right there. You get your nice little bounce and your bop going. Get the spinning around, going backwards. Yeah. Yeah, it's been a while since I've been skating. Holy crap. It's been maybe about 3 years since I took the family skating, man. That was crazy. We got to do that soon. Might have to organize a CMA skating party. Have casters fly in to the, from across the country just so we can go skating. I think that would be dope, though. But, yo, if you talk about something that represents the summer, that's it right there. That's it's upbeat. It's light. It feels good. You know, we got that right tempo. That's cruising. That's barbecuing. That's playing ball. That's at the swimming pool. That covers a wide range of events. So, props for capturing that, my man. You handled that business. My dude, no one, you have been killing it, sir. Thank you. Please continue. That's all I can ask. Thank you, my man. All right, we're going to keep it moving. We're going to head down to South Carolina. Oh, I'm sorry. Is it North Carolina? One of the Carolinas. And I'll have my dude who's chilling in the chat with us right now. My man, Ron P.
Summertime is awesome.
this guy right here, man. Good freaking Lord. Dog, the number of hearts and likes that have just popped up over the last section of that song. It's ridiculous. This joint is fire. Holy crap, Ryan B. That's another dude. He has been absolutely murdering it since the entire time he's been here. And you know, he had to disappear for a couple of months, but especially since he's been back, he's unstoppable. No, I can't give you that title. But yo, that joint is dope, man. Very dope. He said, this is a feel-good song for the summer. Just thought about hanging out with my son and friends and playing some b-ball. There it is. Plain and simple. It definitely fits that emotion, that event, you know, whatever. It definitely has those qualities, my man. I love everything about that. The intro, I love when it actually kicks in with the music, all the sounds you picked. Very dope. I especially love it. I think it's around the 150 area where the music actually broke down. I think the drums had dropped out. And he had like sounds of kids playing in the background, like out in the street or in the backyard. Man, that's what it's all about, yo. Oh my God, that's taking me back to my youth. And it's so crazy because, you know, we're all, the majority of us are of age and married and have kids. So, you know, as I just did this summer with my kids, you know, we get a chance to get out and play around and run around the backyard a little bit. We all have scooters, so we, you know, kicking up and down the street on the scooters, that kind of thing. Enjoy all of that stuff. And having my boys takes me back to my childhood. I love playing around with them. So when he's talking about this in his song, what that would be the purpose, or just having fun, summer fun in general. That fits it right there, my man. You are a beast. Thank you for that. You are an absolute beast. Shout out to my man Slade 5000 who just checked in. Thank you, sir. And there's a few other people who are checking in. I would definitely get you shouted out. Make sure you get your likes in. That way I could actually see that you checked in. And I will make sure to shout you out before the end of the night. So thank you all for watching. All right, let's keep it going. We're going to head over to my man over in Maryland, the great Ray Gene. took a week off. Now he's back with a vengeance. Ray Jean with the heat. Holy crap, dude. That was nasty. Wow. That right there, yo. This dude, if you really didn't pick up on it, I don't know what to say. But he kind of went with his own interpolation or tribute to cover of Summer Madness. You can tell that with the bass line, definitely. And there was a couple other elements in there that actually contributed to sounding like the original. Very, very dope. It did, but it didn't. That's what I really, really appreciate about that. Then what he did as the song progressed, first of all the sounds are incredible. Dude is great with his instrumentation. He's completely organic. 98% of the time, he's organic. So all of the stuff that he chose for this particular song, perfect. Then the way the song progressed and changed up, stupid. Absolutely stupid. Got it. He had it break down in a couple of parts to where it's like no bass line. It's just like keys or pads going. Then he had like a really dope high synth in there. But then it gets to after the 2 minute mark, like the last, I guess you could say, third of the song. And then this dude actually had horns in there. He had a brass section in there. Stupid. Oh my God. Ray Jean, I don't know how you do it, bro, but I'm glad you do. That was excellent, my man. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Thank you for that. Good Lord. Handling biz. Shout out to Brandon Gillette up in here. Thank you for coming through, my man. Travis Nelson, thank you for coming through. Couple new people, man. I'm enjoying this. Shout out to my man, Smoke. What up, dude? Miss Lynette Smith, thank y'all for coming through and checking this out. Yo, this is becoming a very, very good show. And we still got more to go, so sit back and enjoy it. Coming up next, my dude representing Jersey, now living in Florida, the guy that we call Hammer Time. My man, DJ Widebody. We'll be right back. the great one, DJ Widebody. Good freaking Lord. Yo. You are out of control, man. That was nasty. Holy crap, yo. First of all, before I go any further, major props on the drum work, which he is, I've said it so many times, he is excellent with like fills and transitions and whatnot. Excellent with that. And then the drum selection. Oh my God, those drums were so crisp. They sound so damn good. That set that track off. Dog. The sample he used, and he just said in the chat that he used it in a couple of different samples. But the summertime. Oh my God. Woo! Widebody is a beast. Good Lord, dude. What in the hell is wrong with you? Yo, that by far is the best track I have heard from you thus far. You murdered that, dude. You absolutely murdered that. Thank you. Good Lord, man. Woo. Shout out to Disciple Die checking in. What's going on, my man? I gave a shout out to my man Smoke. Shout out to Cap L checking in with us tonight. My dude, thank you for coming through. Man, who else have I not spoken to? Good Lord, this has been a great show so far. Miss Lynette Smith, I think I shouted you out, but I shout you out again, no problem. Brandon Falls, thank you. Who else we got? I think that's it for now. Man. This show has been incredible. Shout out to my man Needle914, just checked in. What up, dude? Thank you. All right, let's keep it moving. What up to Third Degree, who just checked in as well? My man. To a gentleman, a couple of joints back. It's like, you know what, Taj? Don't even play my joint, please. Well, guess what? It's you're up next. Shout out to my man, Dixie Freely. We'll be right back. currently residing in St. Louis. The guy who is now a part of the Air Fryer Lemon Pepper Wings Club. He and Miss Tiffany. My man, Dixie Freely. I don't know what the hell you were talking about, bro. That was dope. I love the, I think that was a Sly and the Family Stone. Yeah, that was a Sly and the Family Stone drum break. I love the way you use that. And then, of course, you got the Go Brooklyn chant in the background. But he said he used a number of samples with this. It was Minnie Riperton's Memory Lane, PM Dawn's Die Without You, and the Sly and the Family Stone break. But I love what he said. He was like, I wanted to make a joint that reminded me of the days with my cousins, where my cousins and I were playing spades at my grandmother's house under the umbrella table. If the radio blasting and Kool-Aid filled red solo cups. That's summer right there, yo. That's it. That's the that is summer right there. All of those elements equal summer. That's it. That's what it's all about. Way to kill that. I loved everything about that. The intro was dope. But when the drums actually kicked in and then the rest of the song actually kicked in and it just flowed and progressed, dog, especially because he said, you know, he wanted to take it back to, you know, childhood. I'm assuming like teenage, you know what I'm saying? Mid to late teenage years of doing this. So at that point, you know, we're all around the same age. That's definitely in the 90s, especially with the grimy sound of this particular track, at least the background of it. That definitely puts you in the mind of what was on the radio back then. And I really appreciate that. But like I said, he had the drum break in there. He had some other instrumental elements and samples in there. Nice little high synth in there in a couple different parts. Stupid. Had a nice little breakdown. I believe that was around the 120 in that area. Absolutely nuts, man. You are nasty. That was dope. And shout out to Miss Tiffany for whatever she's doing to keep you rocking like this. Thank you both. Shout out to Zod, stepped in the building. Zod McGill, thanks for coming back, my man. And I think I got everybody for now. Make sure you get your likes in before the end of the show, and I will definitely be sure to holler at you. All right, let's keep it going. We're going to head West Coast now. Holler at my dude who got a chance to come hang with us tonight, my man, Gemini. 4D. We'll be right back. Gemini 4D. What the hell was that? Dog, the chat lit up as soon as this joint hit. He used a variety of things. We'll get to that in a second. But just having that My Life in the Sunshine, the Roy Ayers joint, in the beginning. But the way he tuned it so when those synths hit, it sounded so crazy. Absolutely nuts with that. I love the way, I love Gemini's chops and his drums, specifically in his submissions. They are always just way far away from what everybody else is doing. And I really, really appreciate that. He definitely has his own style. I've said that multiple times. So he has a lot of that going on, of course. But then joint progressed and he got to, wow. He had a nice little breakdown, but then he went through like, I want to say it was like 3 or 4 different transitions where he had different songs. It was Summer Breeze that was in there. It was, like I said, My Life in the Sunshine. It was Summer Madness. It was one more. I'm blanking out right now that was in there. But the fact that he went through and was just, as it progressed, it just got stupider. That's the best way I can describe it. It just got even more stupid as it went on. Killed it. Gemini is an absolute beast. Good Lord, man. I'm glad you got a chance to check in with us and watch live this week. Good Lord. Whew. That was nuts. A couple shout-outs. Shout-out to my man Woo Child is hanging in with us tonight. Thank you, sir. Thank you for coming through. We also got Aisha. I'm not going to attempt to pronounce your name and screw it up. Thank you, Miss Aisha, for hanging with us. somebody else that actually stepped in. My bad for not getting you called out right now. But like I said, make sure you get your likes in before the end of the show, and I would definitely call you out before we finish. This has been, woo, Lord. Good Lord right here. This has been pretty freaking dope. Now, this gentleman right here has been probably the most consistent. No, not probably, the most consistent with submissions and progression in the last 3 years. We all love and respect him. We all anticipate what he's going to do each week. So shout out to my dude, DJ Locturnal. more times than not, I'm left absolutely speechless after a DJ Locturnal submission. This is no exception. I don't know what is going on. I encourage it. And what is going on in his life, I'll say that. I encourage it. We have absolutely created a monster. This dude is a monster. He is easily one of the dopest musicians I have ever come across. Every single week, he does it like this. He continues to progress. He continues to get better and better every freaking week. Every year. Like I said, he's been with us for 3 years now. What the hell, dude? This was incredible, dude. Said he used a Summer of 84 multi-pack. I'm assuming that's like a sample pack or something. Miami Vice type score, which I can definitely hear that. I built the track that progressed through summer, through the summer fun season, into the end of summer blowout, which is what we're having right now. Dog, this, again, his stuff sounds unlike anybody else, which is, I always appreciate that about everybody that we rock with has their own sound. You would be hard pressed to find two people that sound alike here at CMA. Real talk. And even on the outside of CMA with the people that we're affiliated with, it's still everybody has their own sound. Shout out to everybody for that. Thank you. But this dude has this, I don't even know how to describe it. And I'm actually very good with words. I do voiceovers for a damn living. But I don't know how to describe Locke's sound other than it's damn good music. That's it. And he continues to get better and better and better. This was sick. Especially, as he said, it had a progression and it evolved. The first half, dope. Very dope. Second half, when it got into the upbeat double tempo, double time tempo kind of thing, Locke. For real, dude. Then it slowed down just a little bit. Or I should say he lost some of the elements and then brought it back in and ran it and ran the beat out. Dog, you my man. For life. Locke, you are a beast. Thank you, sir. Woo. All right. Let's bring it back up to Detroit. Holla at my man, Sho-Nuff.
Hey, babe, you ready?
Oh, yes, I am.
Cool. I got everything in the car packed and ready to go.
And I just got off the phone with Mom.
You got the tickets. Hey, son.
Yeah, Dad.
Your brother and your sisters are settled in.
Okay.
You good?
Oh, yeah, Dad. You know I got this.
Okay, well, we're going to get on out of here.
Okay, listen. You and Mom have a great time. You guys deserve it.
Thanks.
absolute beast, my man, Sho-Nuff. And I haven't used it in a while. Sho-Nuff shows up and shows out. Period. Killed that. I love what he said for his submission. Married couples with kids will relate to this one. I love that intro where, you know, he did all the voices, obviously. That was so dope because you can envision, you know, again, for those of us who have children, envision getting everybody together early in the morning or whenever. Getting everybody together so you can go on that summer trip, family vacation, go to the amusement park, whatever. You could definitely envision that with how, you know, he set the song off. And then I'm assuming, or I'll speak from my point of view, after that intro, at that point, that's everybody in the car traveling. And you can kind of see different shots of everybody, you know, doing whatever they're doing, you know. The father most likely is driving and the wife is, you know, kind of chilling, just sitting, looking out the window, smiling or whatever, enjoying the ride. Kids are in the back playing on phones, playing games, whatever. I can see all of that with this track, but the music and the singing and Sho is just so dope with everything that he does. This was really laid back, really, really dope. Very, very summer, dog. Way to kill it, Sho. I haven't seen him in here tonight, but I'm pretty sure he's going to catch the podcast. You, sir, are a beast. Thank you for that. Good Lord. Woo! All right, let's keep it moving. Holla at the guy. I'm really anticipating this. My man, Mr. Wallace.
We'll be right back.
What did I just experience? What was that? This guy, Mr. Wallace, yo. This dude. Let me just read from his submission, because he typed a little bit. This summer, I really got a chance to learn a lot about outboard gear with the Scratch Magazine team. Shout out to Gadget and all of our people that we rock with over there. This is my ode to another CMA affiliate, Digital Hustle affiliate, Fat Von Freeze, love for distortion. Pay close attention. I made it with a pair of rusty nails, a graham cracker, a nickel, and a Game Boy. Oh, God. I said, thanks for the inspiration. And listen to this lineup. It samples Erykah Badu's Times of Wasting, Dandelion Wine's Hot Dog, Raphael Cameron's In Love, and Dennis Coffey's Scorpio. In freaking credible, dude. That joint is so... I don't even know what to say, how to describe that joint. It has energy, it's upbeat, it's dope. Oh my God. It's really, really, really hard to describe that. The drums are absolutely nuts. He did a nice amount of distortion and compression and really pushing those drums and make them hit, but they don't sound overly distorted. They still sound very, very beautiful. The samples, good Lord, especially with all of that, stupid, the way he arranged the chops and everything. And then, of course, you know, he has his snare that has like a clap and a tambourine kind of thing. He normally does similar to that. The way this joint progressed and changed up a few times, and then at the, I'm going to say 250, switched into an entirely different beat. Still the same sound as far as the overdrive and distortion, but completely different beat. Stupid, dog. Wallace. Start calling you MacGyver for real. We're gonna take that from Fat Von and put that title on you, dog. Woo! My man. Thank you, sir. Oh my God. That was dope. And now, to close out this journey, this season of summer, the man that's going to take us home, RTO Beats. RTO Beats closing out episode 137 of the weekly homework assignment / podcast. Really, Doug? Really? Really? First of all, before I go into what he actually did, let me say, that's like the perfect ending to this podcast. This podcast has been excellent. Nothing but heat. Absolute heat. And I love how it just seems to work out like this, especially with the live shows. The show just has a progression where it starts off at a very good level, a very good high, so to speak, and it just goes up. It just elevates and gets better and better and better as the show goes on. Shout out to everybody that participated for that. The other thing I wanted to say about this song is, yo, if that doesn't sound like summer, I don't know what it sounds like. Kind of coming off of, if I were to use the last three tracks where Sho had the song with Giving Everybody Together, They're Going to Travel. Wallace had the track where it's going throughout the day and you see them doing whatever activities they're doing, hitting the beach or whatever. And then RTO's track is the going home track where everybody's just kind of chill, taking it easy on the way home. People might be knocked out or on the way to being knocked out as they're riding back in the car. The sun is setting. Sky is still very clear, and it's just all really dope. Those last three, I mean, the entire podcast was on point, but that last three was freaking perfect. I love how these podcasts, how they progress and how they end up, man. He said, and I heard it, he sampled Ramsey Lewis and Earth, Wind, and Fire, Sun Goddess, one of my favorite songs of all time. Actually, I got the record sitting right over here. Also sampled Dave Grusin's Play Era, I believe that's the name of the song. Had some bass and strings, delayed chime. Killed it. Absolutely killed it. Again, I love the feel of this track. Again, it's that going home, sun's going down, everybody's just kind of cooling out, reflecting on the day, get home safe, call it a night. Beautiful, beautiful track, man. Seriously. And somebody, I forgot who it was, apologies, but somebody said this is a masterpiece. Yes, I agree. I absolutely agree. I loved everything about this track, dude. Everything that you did within it, everything, all of the sounds, the way it progressed, the way it ended, even. Katie said, you know, I put a little something in there for you. You know, RTO is from Oakland, the Bay Area. So he came up listening to RBL Posse and oh my God, so many people. But I'm a big E-40 fan. I always have been. And he put that last sample in there, which is actually the sample used for Sun Goddess, is Yayo by E-40. I hope I don't go back to slanging Yayo. I love that track. Woo! So he put a little snippet of that in there at the end. Way to kill it, RTO. You did it again. Real talk, my man. Way to kill it. You, sir, are an absolute beast. As well as everybody else that we rock with tonight. So shout out to RTO Beats, Mr. Wallace, Sho-Nuff, DJ Locturnal, Gemini 4D, Dixie Freely, DJ Widebody, Ray Jean, Ron B, No One You Know, DJ D-Man, OK Joey, and my man Mental to God. Thank y'all for participating. And let's give some shouts out to everybody who is rocking with us tonight. No One You Know, Dixie Freely, Mike Notes, Agent Smith, my man, we'll keep the light on for you. DJ D-Man, RTO, my man Demi Glass, thanks for coming through, dude. Ray D, my man, he came through and he gave us that intro, shout out again for that. Mr. Wallace, Jamari Mack, Necromantis, what's up, dude? Thanks for coming through. Third Degree. My man Smoke is in here. What up? Cap L. DJ Locturnal. Did I shout him out already? Anyway, DJ Locturnal, DJ Widebody, my man Wade, thank you for coming through. Slade, 5,000, thank you. Illtone, Howard Knox, J. Mitch, Basement Chemistry, QB, Quentin Barrett, my dude. And then major shout out to QB. He has been a huge, proponent, advocate of what we do at CMA, especially the podcast, for the last couple of years that I've known him, and I'm eternally grateful. He's been bringing new people in on a regular basis. He's constantly sharing the podcast. He's one of the first people in the chat every time we do a podcast. So shout out to you, my man. Thank you. Thank you for all of that. Shout out to Miles, Ray Jean, Gemini 4D, my wife Samaya. Welcome, Chris Cash. Thank you for coming through. Disciple Die. Oh, is that who I think it is? Oh, Jay Philt, welcome, my man. Thanks for watching. Disciple Die, Miss Tiffany, Wu Child, Miss Aisha, thank you for coming through. Zod McGill, thank you for coming through again, my man. We got Brandon Gillette, thank you. Miss Lynette, Big Hub, thank you for coming through. Brandon Falls, thank you for coming. Jelani Hennifer, I can never say that name. I'm just going to say Jelani. Thank you for coming through, Jelani. Euphabian Rowland, Miss Pam, Toussaint, Miss Lena. And let me make sure I didn't forget anybody else. I think we covered everybody. Yes, I think we covered everybody. This has been an excellent episode. Shout out to everybody that participated. Shout out to everybody that watched live and everybody that's watching the rebroadcast or the playback. We do this every Monday night, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, right here on Facebook.com/Computer Music Academy. Then we post the official podcast on YouTube.com/Computer Music Academy, as well as ComputerMusicAcademy.com the next day. If you would like to be amongst the great talent pool here at CMA, come on over to ComputerMusicAcademy.com and join us. It is that simple. I'm done for the week. Enjoy the rest of your week, and I will talk to you next time. See ya!